unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
This week's exclusive performance.
So welcome along to Worcester University then, showcasing some of the very best musicians that we've got from across Herefordshire and Worcestershire. Next artist has moved from Ross-on-Wye, he's now living in Worcester. He's one of the most prolific songwriters that we've got in our area. Also works as a frontman of Dandelion Killers, and I've never met a band who gig more than these guys. But lately, he's been doing more and more solo shows as the Admiral Daydream and the Stolen Souvenirs. It's a weird name, but I don't care. Ladies and gentlemen, please put your hands together. Adam Daffurn.
Oh, bless you. Thank you. All right. I just heard the news, and it's broken me when you spoke to me. You gave up on me, and I just can't be true. Reflecting back so perfectly, and should I try and not survive, we'll never make it out alive, 'cause I'm not one of reflecting back so perfectly, and should I try and not survive, we'll never make it out alive, 'cause I'm not one of us. This is called The Longest Day Since Records Began. Long long lost shores lap at your feet. Once more you turn to me and warm with a face like the sea. Oh, scorn and no subtlety, so make up your mind. What do you mean? And try to decide. Then we can all go and leave this behind. S.O.S. distress signal sent. Oh, let the troubles ahead commence and give it a rest. Who said, but in my defense, what do you mean? The line in the sand, and try to deceive. Then we can all go home and finally began. Your soul has taken my hand and hearts of everyone, and I don't understand. My mind overboard, the line in the sand traced back to the shore. Now that we've all gone home, apparently cured, who knows who we did it for? Just go, don't say so low, but that was the longest day since records began. Your soul has taken my hand. Whoa. Thank you, cheers.
See our session snaps right now.
bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
So when you're not being Admiral Daydream, what's your real name?
Adam Daffurn. Not quite as clever or funny. Or just...
I've never heard of Daffurn, though. That's
Daffurn? Oh, no, we're rare. Yeah. It's more over the border in Hereford. There's lots of us there.
Oh, okay. So where did the Admiral Daydream name come from? Because that's a lovely...
I think that was my lovely girlfriend, fiancé now, who, yeah, she thought it all up for me because I don't have... the ability to think of thoughts myself.
So, and how long have you been playing solo now?
Well, forever, really. Yeah. It's just, obviously, doing Dandelion Killers and all the other bands I'm in, it's kind of, there's always things that get left over and little ideas that aren't suitable for kind of noisy bands. So
they work well?
Well, yeah, all the quiet seeds just grow underneath, and I just do it myself.
So when did you start playing music?
I don't know, it was just always about, when I was about... 5, 6, probably. Oh, I used to use the clothes era as a microphone stand and put a microphone in that. And yeah, that's when I started.
Did you make it any good sounds? Did you
record
any?
Oh, it's brilliant. I had a platinum album and everything. It's great.
And what can people expect from like a stage show? I like your velvety tux that you're wearing at the moment.
Yeah, this is my velvet
tux. Very swish. Are you quite a traditional dresser, or is this normal kind of?
This is my normal. This is my normal standard Daffurn attire. Yeah. This is what I wear normally.
So the man on stage is the same as the man in the street?
Pretty much, yeah.
But what about when you're not playing music, when you're not in the band, when you're not solo?
If I'm not actually playing the music, I've got an internal musical going on in my head. Not like a musical like Oliver or something, just music going on in my head. So it's always
in a mad way, or in a...
Yeah, in a mad way, in a slightly deranged, psychotic way.
Well, what about a quick 3, 2, 1? I'd like to know three dream venues or festivals that you'd love to play at.
Dream venues or festivals?
Yeah.
Okay, Reading and Glastonbury, obviously, for the festival-y type of thing.
Yeah.
Dream venue. For ages, with Admiral stuff, I wanted to do like a tour of churches and cathedrals.
Ooh,
just because they're all
lovely.
Echoey. So, yeah, a church, a cathedral. Notre Dame, there we go.
Oh, wow, nice, yeah, why not? Set your sights, yeah. Oh, beautiful.
I could be like Quasimodo.
but much better looking without a hunchback.
I'm not even sure that's
without
okay.
Without some weird gypsy following you around everywhere as well. Yeah. Doing one of those. What about two bands or musicians that you would love to gig with?
Mike Patton, just doing any of his crazy stuff, because I think he's fantastic.
Yeah.
Joanna Newsom.
Yeah, I can see that. Well, I was listening to a lot of your stuff actually and thinking that would sound really nice with a slightly, you know, female harmony up there or something. That sort of thing would work lovely, I think.
Yeah.
Okay. And, okay, I'm a girl, I love a bit of gossip. Mm-hmm. So my number one, I'd like a great fact about you or just an interesting fact that I wouldn't have known, but I couldn't tell from looking at you.
I used to work on Hollywood films.
How really?
Yeah, I used to make sets and props.
What was the best thing you made?
The best thing I made was a bit of the TV dome for Charlie and the Chocolate Factory.
Wow. That's cool. There we go. Watching it back, being like, look at that. I made it. And everyone was like, quiet, watch the film.
Oh. Yeah, usually your name is right at the end of the credits and you're the only one sat in the cinema. I go, oh, there I am.
If you're writing music in Herefordshire and Worcestershire, be part of it. Upload your music to bbc.co.uk/Hereford and Worcester/introducing.
Thank you. Cheers. Lovely sunny day, I thought I'd play something horrifically depressing. But the sentiment is lovely. This is my last one. Thank you very much for clapping and stuff. It was lovely. This sounds better with accordion on it, but no one will play accordion for me. And I asked a Polish man in the street the other day if he'd play accordion for me, and he didn't understand what I meant. This is called Seven Summers.
All you can do to stop yourself from crying is smile and say you're not afraid of dying. With such sincerity, I can't tell if you're lying. Not that it matters now. It didn't hit me until yesterday. I couldn't quite remember how to pray. Well, all of a sudden it came flooding back to me. When I awoke, I was still on my knees. I felt the tears dried upon my skin, like a bruise reminding me to think of things I'd rather not be thinking about today. Things I'd rather not have heard you say. But then the autumn came, and with it all so came the rain. Seven summers passed just like that. Just click of fingers, a drop of a hat. Beneath the shade of such a humble sky tonight, I can't remember what you really like. But all you can do is to stop yourself from crying is smile and stay. Not afraid of dying with utter dignity. No one can tell you're lying, not even you. That image burned itself onto my mind. I see it every time I shut my eyes. Take away forever, you declare. I'll try my best or I'll die trying, I swear. But then the autumn came, and with it all so came the rain. When the autumn came, suddenly we're as right as rain. Dying with such sincerity, and no one can tell you're lying, not even you. Thank you very much for having me. See you soon.
Unsigned, undiscovered,
and under the radar music.
This week's exclusive performance.
BBC introducing
in Hereford and Worcester.